Carnation Market was established on the 22nd of September in 1979 under the Armed Forces Revolutionary Council led by Flight Lieutenant Jerry John Rawlings. But in 2019, this is the situation here. And what you find is not difficult to see here each time the Carnation Market comes in focus. It's one of the biggest markets in West Africa, if not the biggest. But every time you will find heaps of refuse here, right in the center of the market. And questions have been raised about the insanitary conditions at the market, especially knowing full well that food is sold here to persons from all walks of life. The Carnation Market also plays host to a lorry park running through many suburbs in Accra and also some parts outside Accra. It also has, as its neighbors, the Carnation Police Station and the Carnation Post Office, one of the oldest in the country. The market women have refused to speak to us because they claim the last time we were here to make a story or report, the management of the market came after them and actually sacked them. Because if you look behind me, you can clearly tell that the market is overflown. The stalls in there are full. So the market women have come out here, which necessitated the creation of the red line policy by Mayor Van der Poy at the time. Now, they have overflown and they are out there on the pavements, the walkways, actually. And they say they will not speak to media because the last time they did, the market authorities came after them. More like they're being gagged from not speaking up. We've taken a cursory tour of the communities around here, the Bubuashi, the Kanishi, the Awudoma area. And we realized one striking thing, that sanitary sites were not readily available. And so what it is that the people who live in the households who are not signed on to any waste management plan or policy would bring their refuse to this location. And we see tractors and trucks working. Earlier, there was one big truck here who had come to haul some of the refuse and take it away. And there's still a mountain of it. The smell here is funny. And to think that food is sold right at this premises is very, very disgusting indeed. But that is the true state of the sanitation situation at the Carnation Market, where every now and then, refuse builds up. And one continues also to wonder how sanitation is managed here, because the market women were told, pay tolls or pay something to ensure that the place is kept clean. But right after they have paid what they pay, what level of education is given to them to ensure that they also don't litter and people from their homes also don't come with their refuse to compound the already challenging situation that they have here. Right next to this heap of refuse is a public toilet that's managed privately. There's one originally inside the market, but this one is privately managed. And you can tell the busy activity there. People are taking money to allow for people to respond to nature's call. So at the Carnation Market now, you can see the gentleman, a staff of the AMA, is sweeping to gather what is left of the refuse. And it's so disappointing. I was trying to speak with one or two persons who are not market women, who are just passing by, to share with us what their immediate thoughts are. Hello, madam. Good morning. Good morning, sir. How are you, chief? We are live on TV3 now. Bolani Obi Eto Joyden.
Hey, sana lo bolani. Moni bolani jule biye na behi kwa. Si boni biye yopo. Mene mene biye bon sana mena. Ake bolani jule biye le. Hey. Esa ne bolani jule biye na ka. Sana ana avalo na ka bolani biye. Bolani be mo ne be. Hela sone ba hama hama biye. Ke hama hela biye. Ba yake government fe ne ke government fe. Who is the government? You boni ten you.
Kef yo ba he oni ni biye.
Ba he oni ni biye.
Niko ba he ni biye. To filo den.
Oh be. Unfo biye ba. Yeah, they inform me about. We are back. I just want me at my in those area. No one in show be any ya. But that is man. Be able to be any. No, be any be. They say now look at low. Be any be. Eba he.
So essentially, he's saying that the rubbish is not supposed to be here, and that he believes it should be taken away because each time he comes here to buy food stuff, and he doesn't come here regularly though. But each time he comes here to buy food stuff, he says he finds it so disappointing. And he was amazed also that each time the complaint comes, people will focus on the government and say, well, the government needs to clear this, the government needs to clear this. But he's asking a big question, who is the government? Who is the government? Madam Etiseng. Good morning. That's a confirmation there of what it is. The smell is unimaginable, is unthinkable, and you would think that in the 21st century, when the president has declared that by the end of his 2020 tenure, Accra will be the cleanest city in Africa, one would see a change in the way we generate and handle refuse. Elsewhere in the world, this is a gold mine because it will be reused, it will be recycled, and it will be processed into compost and other usable stuff. But here in our country, we jam everything together, from plastics to organic waste, and we just leave it to ferment and smell. And that's the situation here. Johnny Hughes, TV3 News, Garbage Out Campaign, Kalishi Market.